And
I'm like, COVID has been causing a lot of deep conversation with myself, even like between my husband and I. But I feel like a lot of people and couples don't have meaningful conversation or even friends, just
relationships in general.
But we don't have these conversations because we're scared on not agreeing or offending somebody. And so I'm like, you know, I've been talking to you with this video, I'm gonna make it. And so recently
we found out that
Chadwick Boseman had stage 4 colon cancer.
When he found out that he had it,
so cancer stage from basically 1 to 4, 4 being the worst, it's probably metastasized, spread to other areas of his body. Even stage 3,
it's probably like a large
mass, even some risk for metastasizing, meaning traveling to other areas of the body, spreading to a lymph nodes or other organs. And, you know, a lot of people were just heartbroken. Said how much they miss him and how grateful they were that he made so many wonderful movies, and he was just an overall great person. And like, I made a video on Instagram and I said that, you know, Black Panther was the greatest contribution.
And you know, I got a lot of questions.
I just wanted to talk more about it, right? Why would I say that's not his greatest contribution? I also mentioned how I don't have a hero. Why do I say I don't have a hero? I just wanted to go more into detail, have this conversation, and just be honest to you all about it. I think it's very important because a lot of us are lost. And please listen to the whole video, listen to the explanations that I give, so that way you can understand my perspective. And if you feel a different way, please comment it. If I miss something, or if I'm like lacking knowledge on something, please let me know. This is like deep conversation. Let's have meaningful combos. And I'll probably start making more videos like this, because I have a lot of topics that I'd like to talk about. So basically, I
said that
he's not a hero, and I said that, his movies are not his greatest accomplishment. Why? I say this because, for one, we cannot attribute any action to
our own strength.
Wisdom to our own strength. We have to give God acknowledgement. To me, in my opinion, and I may be wrong, this is why we're having a meaningful conversation, Chadwick Boseman's greatest accomplishment
while on this earth
is giving glory to God. If you look at his speeches, if you look at his interviews, he mentions
God at least
once. Okay? He, like, has full-on sermons. He drops tokens and valuable information in his speeches. And as Christians, as living beings, we
have to give glory
to God. So that is his greatest accomplishment. Okay? Chadwick did not get these scenes, get
these parts, major
parts, depicting Black accomplishment for no reason. Okay, so for one, to be a Christian, which he,
from my opinion, what
I could see, the way he lived, what he talked about, he was a true Christian. To be a Christian, you have to
confess with your mouth
and believe with your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord and Savior. Once you do that, you are saved. Now, your actions should begin to reflect you being saved in Jesus Christ. have to allow Jesus to enter into our hearts. We have to believe. We have to first give him permission. Not that he needs our permission. God doesn't need permission to do anything. As you can see, COVID, the fires in California, we didn't need our permission to do anything. But all things work together for those that love the Lord and to give him glory. Okay, so as individuals, we open ourselves to God working in us, right? If you follow witchcraft, you open yourself to voodoo and whatever else, to demons and Satan, right? And you pray to that being that you believe is your God, right? So whether good or bad, you open yourself up to it. And so Chadwick, he opened himself and he basically gave God permission to use him, right? Even when we see figures in the Bible, they have to be obedient. They have to be willing to put themselves out there, to have faith, to believe that God is going to bring them out on the other side. There are so many examples, okay? But you have to believe and trust in God. And sometimes it doesn't start out with a big action of trust or faith. Sometimes God will whisper and say, give that person a dollar. Or say, I love you. Give that random person a hug. It starts small and then you work your way up to bigger acts, greater acts. Okay, but you have to be willing to be used by God. I think about Moses. Moses had a stutter, but he was given this huge task to save his people.
Right?
He said, me, out of all people, I'm not eloquent. I can't do this. Right? But through God, we can do all things. And so Chadwick, he was ready for the task. And it starts at a very young age. So we have to give acknowledgement to God and recognize where his hand is maneuvering and taking away things and allowing things to happen to us, okay? Like I said, we don't give him, he doesn't need permission to do anything. Whether you
want him to do it or not,
if that's what he feels
should happen, it will happen.
He allows things to happen, right? But at the same time, he gives us freedom of choice, all right? So Chadwick was obedient. He heard God's calling. He prayed about different characters that he would portray. He prayed about movies and shows and plays that he would be in. Which overall we see this man, right? But he's human, he's man. And we are contributing all of these attributes to him. But it's not him, it's God, it's Jesus, it's the Holy Spirit working through him to reach millions of people, okay? And so as a Christian, whether you're famous, whether you think nobody pays attention to you, you're just a school teacher, you're a nurse, you are affecting and coming into contact with people that will receive blessings from you, that will receive a testimony from you, will receive a lesson from you. You may just bless them with a smile or having a great personality.
But it's important to recognize that
we need to,
be smart with our interactions,
right? We need to be wise. That's why we pray about what to do, okay? What's our next turn, right? And Chadwick, he did that. So with his platform, he reached millions of people. Whether Christian or not, whether black, white, blue, if you watch Black Panther, you watch some of the interviews that he has done, he affected you. He showed you a Christ-like character, which is what we all should strive to do. But is Chadwick a hero? In my opinion, no. Did he do all of these wonderful things on his own?
And I don't even think
if he were here today and if I could interview him, would he give
credit to himself?
He always gave credit to whom it belongs to, and that's Jesus Christ. That's God. That's lot of people wonder, why would God allow Chadwick Boseman to die of cancer and to suffer so? You know?
I'm not Chadwick,
so I don't know the lesson that he gained from it, but what I do know, and I know what we're seeing today, especially with COVID, is that tomorrow is not promised. A lot of people are dying, and I wouldn't want to be one to die before my purpose is fulfilled, and to know your purpose, you have to be one with God. You have to have a regular conversation throughout the day, back and forth with God. Your purpose is ever changing, so that's why that direct communication is needed all day, every day. And one thing I do believe is that his purpose was fulfilled, okay? His purpose, he came here to change lives, to spread the word of Jesus, and now he's in heaven. He's brand new. He doesn't need a cold. He doesn't need intestine. He's no longer in pain. I don't know if he went through chemo or radiation. He has a new body, okay? And more than anything, you think that the moment he died, he was thinking about all of the characters that he portrayed? I highly doubt it. I think he was making peace, and he
probably had been at peace.
Because if you're Christian, you're at peace. You're in a better place than earth could ever be, right? And glory to God for that. And I just think it's really important for people to understand where I'm coming from. And I don't mean to offend anybody, but I have to be true to myself and to my beliefs. And so don't put all of your eggs in a basket into a human being. You will forever be disappointed. And they will fail you in some type of way. Because we're not God. We're not psychic to where we know your exact needs and wants and how things should be done. Right? But before I made this video, I wanted to come with proof and a scripture that God is real. And I didn't think, let me go to James, because this will prove the point. I said, Lord, can you please help me to open up the Bible to a book and a scripture that you feel is fit for the points that I'm trying to convey. Okay, and so I opened up my Bible, and my eyes were directly like just drawn to Psalm 70 and 71. And so let me read it for you. So this is Psalms 70 and 71, and then I'm reading from the English Standard Version. Okay, and so this is, and Psalms is a song basically, and it's David, for those of you that are familiar. He wrote songs and he portrays like how he was feeling. King David has an amazing story of highs and lows. So if you get a chance, you can research and read
the Bible
about King David. Okay, so this is Psalm 70. He says, O Lord, do not delay. So make haste, O God, to deliver me. O Lord, make haste to help me. Let them put to shame and confusion who seek my life. Let them be turned back and brought to dishonor and delight in my heart. Let them turn back because of their shame. Who say, aha? May all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you. May those who love your salvation say evermore, God is great. But I am poor and needy. Hasten to me, O God. You are my help, my deliverer. O Lord, do not delay. So that is Psalm 70. Let's go on to Psalm 71.
It says, forsake
me not when my strength is spent. In you, O Lord, I take refuge. Let me never be put to shame. In your righteousness, deliver me and rescue me. Incline your ear and save me.
Be to me a rock
of refuge, to which I may continually come.
You have given the
command to save me, for you are my rock and my fortress. Rescue me, O God, for the hand of the wicked, from the grasp of the unjust and cruel man. For you, O Lord, are my hope, my trust. O Lord, from my youth, upon you I have leaned. From before my birth, you are he who took me from my mother's womb. My praise is continually to you.
I have been
a portent to many.
But you are
my strong refuge. My mouth is filled with your praise and with your glory all day. Do not cast me off with the time of old age. Forsake me not in when my strength is spent. For my enemies speak concerning me. Those who watch my life consult together and say, God has forsaken him. Pursue and seize him, for there is none to deliver him.
O God,
be not far, from me, O God. Make haste to help me.
May my accusers
be put to shame and consumed with scorn and disgrace. May they be covered who seek to hurt me. But I will hope continually and will praise you yet more and more. My mouth will tell of your righteous acts. Okay? Of your righteous acts. Not of my righteous acts, but your righteous of your deeds of salvation all day. From their number is past my knowledge. The number of people he's given salvation to, nobody knows.
I will remind
them of your righteousness, yours alone. O God, for my youth you have taught me, and I still proclaim your wondrous deeds. So even to old age and gray hairs, O God, do not forsake me. Until I proclaim your might to another generation,
your
power to all those to come. Your righteousness, O God, reaches high heavens. You who have done great things, O God, who is like you? You have made me see so many troubles and calamities. Will revive me again. From the depths of the earth, you will bring me up again. You will increase my greatness and comfort me again. I will also praise you with the harp for your faithfulness. Oh my God, I will sing praises to you with the lyre, oh Holy One of Israel. My lips will shout for joy. I will sing praises to you, my soul also, which have been redeemed. And my tongue will talk of your righteousness. Help all day long. For they have been put to shame and disappointed who sought to do hurt to me.
So,
like I said, between Psalm 70 and 71, that's what I was drawn to. And, you know, you could pick apart the passages and, scripture. And I really feel like this is Chadwick Boseman. We're not perfect as humans. King David wasn't perfect. But one thing about it that this passage mentions, and I'm so grateful for, is that we're here for a short period of time. But But God is working in the young. He starts in your youth. And, you know, He puts people in place in places to help you in your youth. He may come to you in your youth. And a generation
has been forever changed
because of Travis. So his job is done. And he's saying, praises the Lord. He gave God all the credit and all the glory because he is the only one that is capable of saving us and providing salvation to the unknown number. Okay? It's uncountable, unmeasurable of how many people have welcomed Jesus Christ into their lives since he was born, right? And it's nothing that we can do personally as far as actions, right? Not eating pork, wearing a head covering while praying, being modest, not cursing, not drinking.
That is sin.
And God covered all of our sin when he sent Jesus Christ. It doesn't mean that when you're saved, you continue to sin. But there's nothing that we can do that provides us with salvation. Okay, God extended it to us, and we took it because we believed. But it wasn't our action that gave us salvation. It was Jesus Christ dying for us on that cross. Okay, he didn't have to die for us, for my sin, for my children's sin. He didn't have to do it. Not even for you. Not even for Travis. But it was an offering. It was
the most valuable and gracious, tangible thing
that he had, right? Jesus is his son, his Lord and only son. But he loved us so much, the human race, that he gave us a way out. And so I just want all of you to know that it is possible to have salvation as well. Just confess with your mouth, believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord and Savior, and you're worthy of it. There's nothing that you've done, like I said, that stops him from loving you or that will keep you from heaven. Murderers go to heaven, okay? At the very last moment, you can go to heaven. And this is in the Bible, okay? One of the men right next to Jesus, there were three men being crucified.
He professed.
You all to know that, and I want you to attribute all good and bad things to the Lord. Okay, he doesn't need permission to do anything.
And sometimes we give
the devil too much credit when it's not even necessary. Alright, so Travis, he died for a great reason, a greater purpose, and I think he's opening our eyes, and you know, even Kobe Bryant's death, all these young people are dying, millions of people are dying from COVID, both young, old, purple, blue, and black. We need to contribute that to God, okay? And the deaths affect family members, they affect friends, they affect people that we don't even know in a way of saying, okay, I need to get my life together. Let me do better, right? It shouldn't provoke anger or fear. It should provoke motivation.
All right. And